In the last video, we set up our GitHub repo and cloned it locally. Now what we're going to focus on is creating our own branch, adding some changes, committing them, and then pushing them up to our repo on GitHub. Here we are in Visual Studio Code. This is the editor I'm choosing, but obviously you could certainly choose whatever you want. The reason I really like using Visual Studio, especially with Git, is the fact that there is a built-in terminal. What we can do here is right-click and open integrated terminal. Now there are a ton of different commands with Git. Obviously you could just write Git here and it's going to give you all these commands with different descriptions about it. For example, what we've done so far is Git clone. And what we'll focus on here is Git add, which is going to add file contents to the index, and the index being your local branch, your local version of things. And we'll look at Git commit, which is going to record the changes. We'll look at Git branch. We're going to create a branch. And then finally, Git push, which is to push the changes from our local branch up to GitHub, where it will store those changes as a branch there as well. Go ahead and clear this. So first thing I'm going to do is Git branch. And we can see here, it just pulled our main branch, which is that core foundational piece that we're building off of. And that's it. There's nothing else. We haven't created anything new. In order to create a new branch, which is, if you think of it as a tree, you know, that's the analogy here. This is the main trunk of the tree, the main version of everything. And we want to create a branch that we can work on the side, but not actually impact these main files or folders themselves. So now to create our own branch, what we can type is Git branch and then dash C for create, and then the name of the branch. So in our case, we'll do my new branch. We're using the Git command saying branch, using the C flag for create, and then giving it a name, my new branch. Now, if we do Git branch again, it'll show the list of them. And we can see main is still there, and green and this asterisk indicates that that's what we're on. And then my new branch is also there, but that's not what we're currently on. Checkout moves you to that branch. So we can do Git checkout my new branch. And we can see now we're switched to my new branch. And if we do Git branch again, we can see that's where we are. Because we didn't make any changes, these are exactly the same. Now, one thing I'll point out here is if any of this is confusing or you want some more documentation, you can always do something like this, Git branch dash dash help. It's going to open up a help file from Git that you originally downloaded. It comes with it so you can see everything about it, learn what all the commands are, how to use them. So that's really helpful. And now let's try to actually make some changes and add a file to this new branch. In this case, we'll just create a very simple hello world Python file. So we'll do new file, call this hello world.py, and we'll just print hello world. And that's it. Now, if you're in Visual Studio Code, you'll see over here, this connects to GitHub. Now you can set this up to connect to GitHub, and it will track your changes here so you can actually see it here as well, but we won't focus too much on that. Now in this situation, this change is only made on this branch. This new file exists on this branch, but not here. Git status. We can see the branch is up to date with the origin, which is what it was originally branched off of. It's up to date with that. And we can see that it has this hello world file, but it has not been committed. Nothing added to commit, but untracked files are present. So now if we want to actually add this file to our branch, the way we can do that is Git add, and you can say the name of the file. So we could go hello world.py, and this would do it. So if we do this, now if we do Git status, new file, it's green, it's been added to the branch. The other way you could have done that, but let's say you made a change to 50 files or 10 or, you know, whatever, you could do Git add and then just a dot. That would add all of your untracked files here rather than just one. But in our case, we're just doing the one. Now the next step is it needs to be committed. So you can think of add as it's kind of in this holding pattern right before you commit it. Once you commit, like it sounds, it's essentially finalized at that point. So we'll do git commit, and it's going to take everything that you have here that's staged and ready to be committed and add it to your branch. But for every commit, you should add a note, some sort of message indicating what's actually happening within that commit. So what are these changes, these files, what do they represent? To do that, we'll do dash M for message and say, adding hello world file. Oops, I forgot quotations. So we can do quotations around it. And now we can see new branch added hello world file. There's a specific hash involved with that change, with that commit. And now it's no longer just a stage change. It's committed to the branch. It's there. So again, we have these two branches. At this point, we've committed a new change to my new branch, but that doesn't exist on main. So let's see here. We see hello world. If we check out main, hello world goes away because main doesn't have that. If we get check out my new branch, we're back here. It says you're ahead of origin main, meaning this was branched off of that main branch, and it's ahead by one commit, which is what we just did. Right now, this is only locals. If we look at GitHub here and refresh, we go to branches, all we have is main. Right now, GitHub is unaware of this branch that we have here. It's only local to you. And if multiple developers were using it and had their own branches, until they push their changes that they're doing to GitHub, GitHub has no way of knowing about it. So that's what we'll do here now. So let's go ahead and do a git push. Now, what this is saying is in order to push it up, you actually need a remote upstream branch. We'll cover this more in depth on a different video, but essentially what we want to do in this case, and most of the time, is git push origin head. And we can set this by default if we do the config, but we won't for now. Again, let's cover this in a separate video, but to get us going here, we're going to do git push origin head. Now it will understand where it wants to go. And now we can see my new branch is recognized on GitHub. Here it is. We can jump into it. We can see here are the different files. Here's that new file, which if we were to go to just our main, you know, main version here, it doesn't exist. Now we have the ability to switch branches just to see what the files look like. Again, some of these are going to have hundreds of branches potentially. You can switch between them, pull them down, do what you need to do. So now it's available here and we can do what's called a pull request to have people review it. And stuff like that, which we'll cover in a separate video. But that'll do it for this video. At this point, we've now created our own branch. We've made some changes to that branch and pushed that new branch along with its changes to GitHub for us to now review and hopefully get some approvals so that it can get merged into our main branch for everybody else to see and begin to work with.